Many plastic surgeons operate on celebrities, but Dr. Miami is a celebrity in his own right. For years, he's built a social media following by posting intimate videos of his surgeries on Snapchat. And now he's taking his act to TV. Here's ABC's chief business technology and economics correspondent, Rebecca Jarvis.
When we first met Dr. Miami last year,
how nice is his booty look now?
We had a feeling the Snapchatting plastic surgeon was headed for reality show stardom.
Well, they call me Dr. Miami. I'm a plastic surgeon, and I make people feel better about their bodies.
Millions of people are watching as Dr. Michael Salzhauer proudly shows off every incision and tuck in snaps. So graphic, most we can't even show you.
She is quite square beforehand. We're going to snatch her waist, give her a round booty.
And now his fans can see even more of him on his new reality show, Dr. Miami.
I'm Dr. Miami. I do whatever it takes to make people comfortable going under the knife.
Most plastic surgeons operate on celebrities, but Dr. Miami is a celebrity.
Patients are flocking to Miami from around the country for Brazilian butt lifts and mommy makeovers.
How can I help you, Ashley?
I need like a total mommy makeover.
Total mommy makeover.
And they're shelling out thousands of dollars to have Dr. Salzhauer work his magic on them.
For a Brazilian butt lift, it's almost $10,000. For a mommy makeover, it's like with a tummy tuck, it's $12,000 or $13,000.
If you think that high prices and gory snaps like this would have potential patients running for the hills, think again.
My cousin showed me his Snapchat. He won me over.
Travis Richard is here from California.
So I traveled all the way here and getting a brand new butt, so I'm excited.
Patients say Dr. Salzhauer's snaps actually make them feel better about going under the knife.
And I loved every surgery I had seen. I loved the results. Some doctors, they tell you what they want. He would listen, and he did exactly what I wanted.
Samara Joseph came to Dr. Salzhauer for the works. After having a daughter, she was unhappy with her post-baby body.
Breast augmentation, tummy tuck, and then you transfer the fat to the booty.
And says the results were life-changing.
I'm confident in me, and he did that.
Plastic surgery is hard. It's a hard decision to make. It costs a lot of money. There's a lot of bruising, scars, pain.
Oh! Dr. Salzhauer is not your typical plastic surgeon. Undulation.
There's a fine line between creativity and craziness,
but I don't think I've crossed it.
What's going on in here?
His zany personality is part of his appeal.
Watch me as I host my day and my surgeries for all the world to see.
Lord have mercy.
I'm all three Beastie Boys rolled into one. I don't wear it all the time. I don't wear it in the OR. Most people, by the time they come here, they know what they're getting into. And they laugh. A few times, though, their family members are like, are you going to let this guy cut you?
Before and after, it's quite dramatic.
Dr. Salzhauer insists that all this doesn't distract him in the operating room, where life is literally in his hands.
God forbid that worst case scenario. Somebody dies on your table.
We're careful. We hope it never happens.
It's not the first time viewers have flocked to plastic surgery. On the show Botched, millions of fans tuned in to see the good, the bad, and the ugly side of cosmetic surgery. But in Dr. Miami's OR, fans are getting raw, unedited, and unfiltered video almost instantaneously.
All right, so this booty is all done. Look how nice and round it is.
It's everything she ever wanted in a booty and a bag of chips. All of that and more. They still say bag of chips?
Yeah.
Do now.
The concern over unfocused doctors in the operating room has come up before, after legendary comedian Joan Rivers suffered fatal complications during a minor throat procedure. Her daughter, Melissa, sued Yorkville Endoscopy, where the procedure was done, claiming, among other allegations, that a doctor took photos of Joan Rivers while under sedation. The family reached a settlement, and the doctors accepted responsibility. So far for Dr. Miami, no lawsuits, no complications.
If something goes wrong, somebody has the evidence to bring to a court and say, look what he did right here. We have the moment on tape.
I think all surgery should be on tape. I feel like that, what's wrong with transparency? It's like saying to a cop, why are you wearing a body camera? I think that like body cameras on police and cameras in schools are a good thing too. It keeps everybody focused.
In Dr. Salzhauer's office, everyone has a choice.
Has anyone ever come in asked you not to Snapchat their surgery?
Oh yeah, about a third of my patients don't want anything to do with social media.
So you give them the option
of course, of course, yeah. They have to sign permission forms. So about two thirds of my patients Snapchat, do want to be Snapchatted, about a third don't. which is the inverse of what it was in the beginning.
Dr. Salzhauer started out by posting his surgery pics to another social media outlet, Instagram, but says he got kicked off for being too graphic. That's when his teenage daughter introduced him to Snapchat.
So he set up the account, he had no idea how to use it. I had to show him, okay, you press this button, this is how you take a video, and this is a picture, whatever. So then he went to his office and that day he started using it.
The father of five employs not one, but two full-time Snapchatters.
So how was the rest of your Sunday, Brittany?
It was much better. I slept after that IV.
You're recovered after the IV? I heard that you hurled.
No habla ingles.
You did, didn't you?
Everyone in the office is in on Dr. Miami's Snapchat and now reality show game.
And I couldn't do any of this without my phenomenal staff.
Dr. Miami's popularity only seems to be growing and shows no sign of stopping.
This is the best day ever.
We get about 800 calls a day. I had no idea the Snapchat was gonna take off.
But while Snapchat might have made him famous on social media and now reality TV,
you can call me Dr. Miami.
His patients say the work speaks for itself.
The words I said to him when I had surgery was, I wanna look like how God should have made me. And I feel like he did that.
For Nightline, I'm Rebecca Jarvis in Miami.
Our thanks to Rebecca, and Dr. Miami premieres tomorrow on WE TV.